Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Basic of ServiceNow Learning. So in today's video we are going to discuss that what is ACL, how we can create ACL, what is ACL configuration watcher, and how we can debug ACL. In this video we will discuss each and every field of ACL in detail. Okay, so let's move to ServiceNow application to understand ACL in detail. So friends, this is my ServiceNow personal developer instance. Okay, so to navigate to ACL, in filter navigator we have to type ACL. Under system security we have an option called ACL. Click on this. See, once we click on this, we don't have an option to create a new access control. Okay, see, we have lots of options available over here, but we don't have an option to create a new access control. So friend, this is basically a catch, that to create an access control we should need a specific role, then only we can create an access control or we can create an ACL. Okay, so what role we need? We need a security admin role to create an ACL. That is basically a elevated privilege role. Okay, so how we can get that particular role? So to get that role we have to click this. There we have an option called elevate role. Click on that. Here we have a option dot security underscore admin. Click checkbox and then click on OK. So once you click on OK, see, a unlock lock is displayed in front of here. Okay, it means that a particular role is assigned to you. So elevated privilege role is a role which a user can assign to himself for a particular time, means for a 15 minutes or 30 minutes, whatever the timing conditions over there. Okay, that is not a role that you have given yourself and you can do whatever you want at any time. No. Whenever you have to perform a task, you have to assign this role to you and then you can create an ACL. Okay, so once you click on that, see, you have a new button over here in front of access control. It means you can create a new access control or you can create a new access control rule. Okay, so click on this new. See, we have lots of fields over here. Type, operation, admin overrides, application, active, advanced. Okay. So in this video we will be discussing each and every field in detail, that what is basically meaning of that field and how we can configure it. Okay, so before I start with this, let's understand what is ACL first. So ACL basically stands for access control list. Okay, so basically ACL tells that what data user can access and how they can access it. Okay, actually in ACL we define that who all can access what. Okay, it means we are creating some rules in ACL. If user passes that particular rules or satisfied that rules, then only he can access that particular data or he can only access that particular field. Okay, so this ACL is basically used for security purpose. Okay, so this is basically a definition of ACL. Okay, so let's first understand the requirement and then we will work on this form. Okay, so I'm navigating to an incident form. Create new. See, we have lots of fields available over here. Okay, caller, business services, configuration item. So let's take an example that as a requirement I'm saying that you, if the user having a specific role, then only he can write in that particular field. This is basically a very basic requirement, okay, which we can easily implement in ACL. Okay, so it means that if the user have a specific role, then only he can write in this email field. Okay, so this is a requirement for today. So now move to our ACL form. So here is the ACL form. So we have lots of fields like type. So this first field type have multiple options that client callable script include processor, record, REST endpoint, UI page. So friend, most of the time, or we can say every time, whenever we create a ACL, we create for records and UI page, or sometimes for REST endpoints, because rest of the options we did not get a chance to work upon, right? So see, if we select a record, it means we have lots of records for a specific table, right? Incident having a lots of records, problem table having a lots of records. Okay, so when we select a record, see, we have a lots of operations to perform like this: execute, create, read, write, delete. It means if we want that a particular record user can create, then we can select operation as create. If we want that a user can only read a particular record, then we select a read. If we want that particular user can write on that record, we can select write. Okay, so create, read, write and delete are basically four operations which we widely used. Okay, rest of the operations we did not get a chance to work upon. Okay, so we only used four of these operations most of the time. That we give a create we create a create rule, or we create a read rule, or we create a write rule, or we create a delete rule. Okay, same as here, if we select a REST endpoint, see, we have only one operation called execute. The REST endpoint is basically used when we are doing integrations and all. Okay, if we are selecting a UI page, the same as record, we have a multiple options available over here. Okay, so in this video, we are selecting a record. Okay, so we have a multiple operations over here. Okay, execute, create, read, write, delete. So as far as the requirement, I want that only a user which is having a specific role can only write a particular thing. So I'm saying write. Okay, now another option is admin override. What does this admin override means? So this admin override check is checked. Okay, then it means that whatever conditions, whatever roles, whatever rules we have created doesn't meant for admin. Admin can do anything. Okay, that particular restriction will not be applicable for admin. But if we uncheck this checkbox, it means that particular rules admin needs to satisfy, then only he can have access for that particular object or that particular field. Okay, but there is a catch, that if we are only creating a ACL only on the basis of roles, okay, then I suggest that admin override will not work. If you want that admin override uncheck will work, then you have to give some conditions, some scripts and then some roles. Then only this admin override uncheck will work. Now I am checking this admin override right now. Okay, now we have active. That is, if you want that ACL will work, select as active. Otherwise, if you want to disable that ACL, then you can uncheck it. Okay, if you click on advanced, then below you will get a script section. Okay, to write a script. Here, this is the most important field, that is name and this particular drop down. Okay, so what this name says, name star. Okay, so this drop down is basically for table. See, when I hover the mouse, it displays me table. So this drop down is basically used to select the table. For example, if I am creating a access rule for an incident table, then I can select an incident over here. Or if I am creating a rule for a problem table or for a change table or for any other table, then I can select a table over here. Okay. So, but currently here it is mentioned it star. So star means this is basically a wildcard rule of a table. It means that it is applicable for all the tables. Okay. So if you have selected a star over here, it means you are whatever you are mentioning the rules over here, it will be applicable for all the tables. Okay. So what I am doing over here, currently I am writing for an incident table. So I am selecting incident. See, once I select incident over here, see in field section, we have lots of options available. None, star, active. This is basically a field names of an incident table. So if I select none, what does it mean? It means that this ACL is, whatever rules I am creating this ACL is applicable for the table. If the user satisfied a particular rule, he have a access for the table as well as all the fields which are is in the table. Okay, I can say this is basically a super class. Okay, if user has selected incident and none, it means what? And incident and none, and if he satisfied the particular rules which we have created in this ACL, then he must have a access for each and every field. Okay, now if user select star is basically a wildcard rule for a field. Okay, it means that user must have a access for all the fields if he satisfied the particular ACL rules. Okay, but if something is mentioned in incident.none, the previous one, right, then he also must have to satisfy that particular rule as well, then only he have access to all the fields. Okay, now if user select this particular individual fields, okay, then it as it shows that whatever rules is written for that particular field, if user satisfied that particular created rules, then he have access to that particular field. Okay, so currently as per his requirement, what we are going to do, we are writing a ACL for email field, right? See, email field. So I have selected the email. So it means that whatever rules we have, whatever roles, whatever conditions we are giving over here, user must have to satisfy that particular things, then only he can access or he can do a particular activity, write activity. Okay. Description, you can write anything over here. Under definition, what you have to do? It says how the ACL works. So first, user has to satisfy the roles. Whatever roles we have given over here, user has to satisfy the one of the roles, then only he can write in an email field. Okay. The second most important thing is condition, and the third most important thing is script. Okay. I am taking an advance to show the script box. Okay. So it means if something is given in role, something is given in condition, and something is given in script, then user must have to satisfy all the three things, then only he can access to the particular field or he can write in the particular field. Okay. So if condition is not given, okay, it means it is true. If script is not given, it means it evaluates to true. Okay, if we are giving a condition, then user has to satisfy it. Or in case if we are writing a script, then we have to return a value as a true. Then only that particular script will be satisfied as true. Okay, so this is basically a three things or three rules which user has to satisfy to have a access, required access on that field. Okay, so here what I am going to do, I am giving this to a particular role, that a user which is having a specific role can access to that particular field and can write on that. So I'm saying demo role 1 is a basically a role which a user must have to access a particular field. Okay, so here it is done, demo role 1. So I'm not giving any condition over here. Okay, I'm not giving any script. It means condition evaluates to true and script evaluates to true. Okay, so now I'm saving it. So once I clicked on save, see, we have one window. Verify security rules for incident.u_email. incident.u_email is basically a ACL name which I am creating right now. Okay, this is basically, I can say this window is basically a ACL configuration watcher which tells us that what we are going to do. Here we are going to add a new ACL for this particular field. Okay, so this is our ACL configuration watcher which tells us that if we are inserting, if we are updating, if we are deleting our ACL, then this particular ACL configuration watcher tells us that what we are doing actually. So here we are adding this ACL. So I am clicking on continue button. So see, now this incident has been created. Okay. So now to test it, what we will do, we will navigate from the user who is having this particular role to test it whether he is able to write on that field or not. Okay, so I have a user over here, that is demo 1, which is having this particular role. So I am impersonating with demo 1 to test it, navigating to incident. See. See, he is able to write in email field. Okay, because we are already logged in through the user who is having a particular role, so he is satisfying the particular value in ACL. Okay, so now what I am going to do, I am impersonating with some other user who don't have that role. So I believe this demo 2 user don't have this role. So let's navigate to incident now. See, this particular user is not able to write in this email field because he don't have that specific role. So this is basically a ACL, that through ACL we are allowing a user to access the field, to write on the field. Okay, so in this way we can create a ACL for any of the fields which we have in the form. Okay, now I'm impersonating to the system administrator again. So the last topic was the how we can debug the ACL. Okay, so let's see how we can debug. So see here, we system security. Under system security we have debugging. So here we have debug security rules, debug all security. So here I am doing debug all security or debug security rules. Click on this. Once you click on this, it will display script completed in global scope global debug security rules. It means that we can debug the ACL now. So to debug it, let's navigate to a user that having that particular role to test it and to debug it, right? Demo one. So I'm navigating to an incident. See, once I make it as debuggable, then this particular symbols are getting displayed in each and every fields who is having an ACL. So see, we have actually applied for email, right? So I clicked on this. See, it shows me that I have a read true. I can also write true. I can also create true. All are displaying as true. Means this user having all the three operations to perform. Okay. So let's navigate to some other user, test it to debug it. Another user was demo two, right? Here I'm navigating through create new. Again, I'm clicking on this. See, it is displaying as read as true, write as false, because we have created the ACL that a user which is having a specific role can only write in this field. So in this way, we can debug the ACLs as well. Okay. So I'm navigating to a system administrator now. So friends, in this way, we have understand that what is ACL, how we can create a ACL, what is the ACL configuration watcher, okay, and how we can debug the ACL. So I hope this video helps you to understand the ACL in detail. If you like this video, please do share, subscribe my channel. Thank you friends. Bye bye. Have a nice day.